The topics, again, I'll mention all of them in detail in the description, and for the PDF you can like contact me on my Instagram and I'll surely put all the links that I have for you. I just don't understand what's wrong with NATA, because they give us a syllabus and then the questions in the exam are completely different, and basically they are questions that we are not usually going to expect, and that is what has happened from the past two exams, and now there's a third exam. Now I know that a lot of people are very scared and they just don't know what is going to come up in the exam, and there's no proper syllabus, and hence that is why I have like a list of 10 to 15 very, very important questions and very, very important syllabus parts that we are going to get in the third exam. And I'm pretty sure it will be as hard as it was in the first and the second attempt. And the good thing is the score, the cutoff mark can drop down a little bit just because of the third attempt, which is a good thing and a bad thing at the same time. So without any further ado, let me just get into the topics and give you thoda clarity of what is gonna come in the third exam. To be honest, we cannot just trust NATA again for the third time and get betrayed. So we should just be ready with different topics and just unexpected topics that you would never expect in NATA, and then prepare for them as well. So we have here a list, and with the list of what topics we need, I'll even tell you the sources to get the information, because I'm pretty sure you cannot get all of them in books, and you can't just buy so many books of different topics to learn all of that, and that is completely impossible. And I know that a lot of people have been searching for different sources and books that are relevant, and I get a lot of DMs on my Instagram as well, and I try my best to give them the best books for the topics that we have. But not just books, we are going to talk about different sources on Google as well, so which is like very easy to find and which will not be a problem at all and which will not cost you any amount. So let's just go ahead. So the first topic is riddles. Now we have seen a lot of riddles in the first two exams, so these sort of riddles are completely irrelevant to NATA and architecture. I just don't understand why riddles are even important. I think the riddles part come under English, which is unnecessary, but as we know, I don't know why NATA is doing this, but let us just be prepared with English and everything related to English grammar. So when I say everything, we are talking about riddles, we're talking about sentences, and we are talking about the questions that we have seen in the before exams. You can refer normal English books that you had from before. If you don't have them, I think you can easily find them on Google when you just type English quizzes or riddle quizzes, and then you'll have a lot of questions with time, so you can like solve them within time, and which will be very helpful when you're writing NATA, because your exam NATA is time based, and I think a lot of students had trouble with NATA, I mean, because of the time, because people are not able to manage their time while writing the exam, and you're just messing up, and then somehow there's a lot of glitches as well, and somehow you're not able to give the answers that you actually have in mind. So that is a huge headache you have, apart from where to find, where to learn all of these from. So let us just understand that English is important in exam, and you will get a few questions from English. And for that, you can easily find them anywhere on net. You can just type on quizzes on English. So that is the source that you will have, in reach, which is like easily available. So the second thing is architectural terms and architectural knowledge, basically. So for this, we don't have a special book, and that is not a great thing, but it's very easy to find stuff. But you'll have to, have a little patience and then search them from here and there. So I'll give you the sources later. So when I talk about architectural knowledge or architectural questions, first thing, let us talk about materials. So when I say materials, you should also be aware of what materials are used in what type of construction. So when you're talking about temples and stuff, then you should be aware of different types of stone, different type of natural materials and vernacular materials available in each and every place. So there's a lot to cover when we are talking about materials, and we are not just talking about basic materials like brick and I don't know, plastic. We are talking about materials in detail and materials available in each and every different places, as I told you. So that comes under materials. And I will soon make a PDF wherein I'll put all the links of different sources, which will be available if you talk to me on Instagram. You just can, you know, ping me on Instagram and I will forward you the links. So, I mean, not just today, but probably by the rest of, I mean, by the end of the day or by tomorrow, I'll be ready with the list. So for now, I'll just give you a basic, sources that you can get this from. So the second thing is history. So when we're learning about history, you should be aware of different places and different ancient structures of different, you know, like places. So for that, you will need to learn, you can like refer it from history books that you find, history subjects that you find in GK books. And I have mentioned the books in the previous videos wherein I give you a list of books for Nata, and you can like easily find it on my channel. So the next one is climatology, and this you can find easily on SlideShare. So it's basically a website wherein you'll have a lot of PPTs. So you just go onto it and you can type climatology PPTs or climatology terms, and then you should learn all the terms related to climatology, like the basic knowledge that we have, the basic stuff that we learn in the first year of architecture, as in what is wind, what is weather, what is climate, the differences, and what is microclimate and what is macroclimate. You know, all the terms related to climatology, and that is like very important. You will probably easily get 2 to 3 questions. And then the next one is cultural study. Along with history, you should even learn cultural study of different places of India. And next we have brands. So this is something more design related. So you should be aware of different brands as well. Any brands basically. There's no category in brands that we are talking about. So we can't really say what Nata is gonna give you, and we can't really expect what they are gonna give you. So it's better if you cover a lot of brands of different, different topics. And then next we have color theory. Principles, design principles, design elements, and color theory. So all of these three are very, very, very important. And they come under architectural, study or architectural terminology. And then all of them are put up in the description below, so go and check them out. And then next up we have design principles and design elements. So in principles we have symmetry, rhythm, and then repetition. So all of this come, there's different principles and different elements. So in elements you have line, form, texture, etc. So all of this you can find on SlideShare again. So the next one is architectural terminology. So for this, there's a lot of different terms that we should, cover, because when we're talking about architectural terminology, we have stuff from history, we have stuff from monumental architecture, and then we have words from, temples and these structures and different parts of the temples. So again, for architectural terminology, you will find them anywhere on net. Architectural terminology, you don't need special, specific books. The normal books that you have, they too have a few architectural terminology, but then the words are very limited. You just have 1 to 2 sides of it. Like in GK books, they're available, and they're also available in Manorama and RS Agarwal books. But then, instead of just looking at 2 to 3 sides of words, it's better if you go through a lot of words, like around 500 or something. You'll easily find all of these words in, anywhere you go. So this time, instead of just searching for architectural words or color theory, instead of doing that, type color theory PPT and then architectural terminology PPT, because you will easily find PPTs or PDFs with complete syllabus. Like you'll have around 5 to 10 pages, or then you might have 50 to 60 pages. So they're easily available. You should just be aware of how to search them in the first place. So that's a small tip. And then you even have temple plans. I've already mentioned this before. So basically that was it. what I have mentioned, what very important topics that will score you more marks is English, which is riddles and stuff. And then you have all the words related to architectural knowledge, not just terminology, but also, you know, history, climatology, you know, study, and then cultural study, and then color theory, principles, design elements, and you have brands, etc. So these are very important to score more marks. And apart from these, we have different topics like math, chemistry, physics. Probably you just get like 1 to 2 questions, very, very minimum basic questions, which you don't have to be worried about at all. So yeah, that was it. And for the PDF, the topics, again, I'll mention all of them in detail in the description. And for the PDF, you can like contact me on my Instagram, and I'll surely put all the links that I have for you. And it'll be very easier for you to, you know, search like just a click away, and then you can just go to the link and prepare whatever I think are important for the exam. So you cannot just depend on the links that I give you, because that will have minimum information. But for you to find out more, this is just like a push for you, because you just have 15 days to go. So if you like study all of this, it'll be easier for you to understand what more you can get, and you can search them all on your own. So that was it. I hope you understand what you'll get for the exam, and I'll make sure to give the best links possible. Yeah, that was it. Go and subscribe. And also before that, I'd like to tell you that there's a lot of videos related to architecture on my channel that you might want to check out. So that was it. Thank you. Subscribe. Bye.